Welcome. We'll start with Class 6 NCERT Political Science, the second chapter that talks about diversity and discrimination. In the last chapter, we talked about diversity and about India as with the concept of unity and diversity given by Pandit Nehru. Now, in India, as we see, there are lots of differences. These differences are in terms of the languages, the religion, the culture, as we saw in the last class. So, India is home to nearly 8 major religions of the world. All of these 8 religions can be seen in India. It's home to nearly 1600 languages and more than 100 dance forms. Now, how do people differ? They can differ on the way they dress up, the food they eat, the language they speak, as we saw in the last class. But above and beyond, the attitude and the opinion. Now, this attitude and opinion forms the foundation for upliftment of the lower caste, as we'll see further in this lecture. There are two terms that we must be very clear about. One is prejudice and other is stereotype. Now, prejudice involves a kind of biased behavior or a negative feeling associated to something. So, let's say a person who cannot speak English could be considered as a kind of inferior person. So it would be a kind of negative feeling associated to that person, despite the fact that that person can know or knows much better than a person who can speak English. So that's a kind of prejudice that exists. Now, prejudice can also exist based on skin color, based on the clothing. So all these give rise to prejudice. The other phenomena that we would be studying is the stereotype. Now, stereotype is a preconceived notion about something. So, it's something that you fix in your mind or a kind of image that you have. So, let's say you associate the various gender differences. So, boys are not associated with crime. So, that's a kind of prejudice that exists. So, if a boy is seen crying, he might be teased, he might be laughed off at. So, these are the things that occur under prejudice. So, it's a kind of preconceived notion about something. It's not related, not necessarily related to the negative feeling as the case with the prejudice. So, some other kind of stereotypes are, people say all sort of things about me. So, this kind of statement could be heard of from a disabled child. Now, the word disabled is now shifted to children with special needs, giving priority to them. So, now we no more use disabled word, we use children with special needs. And there are certain things which prevent us from doing this. So, the discrimination that has been created is primarily due to the stereotypes and the prejudice that exist in the society. So, the next thing that we try to understand is the inequality or the discrimination. Now, this discrimination can be based on religion. The discrimination can be based on the economic strata, the poor and the rich. The discrimination can be based on a tribal and a non-tribal population. It can be based on the work a person is doing or a kind of job he is doing. So, if a person is doing, let's say, cleaning or picking garbage, that could be considered as a kind of dirty job for some of the people. So, all these leads to discrimination and generate or create inequality in the society. Now, all this, as we said, arises primarily due to the prejudice and the stereotypes that exist or the mental framework that a person has. Now, an interesting example is the Muslim girls are not allowed for education. That's a kind of, again, a common stereotype that exists. But the Muslim girls do not attend school. So, that's again a kind of stereotype that exists. However, in Kerala, 60% of the teachers are female. The government has run specific buses to go to the rural area. So, the female teachers go to the rural area and teach students. And now, the recent finding shows that it's not that the Muslim girl or the girl child is not educated because of the religion, but it is because of the poverty. So, the stereotype is slowly and gradually changing. Or there has been a correct dimension that has been brought to this stereotype. Now, B.R. Ambedkar, who is one of the founding fathers of the Indian Constitution and a great leader to fight for the right of Dalits, experienced the first kind of untouchability when he was 9 years old in 1901, when he was trying to board a train to Goregaon in Maharashtra. And at this station, his father was about to receive him, but he did not turn up for some reason. And later on, when he talked to station master, the station master asked his caste, and he said, "We belong to Mahar." And Mahars during that time were considered untouchables in the Bombay Presidency region. So, and that news spread far and wide, and he was not answered. No one came around. And at last, when there was no one at the station, it was nearly the evening, they were stuck up with how to leave the railway station. And finally, none of the bullock cart person was interested to take him, knowing that they belong to the Mahar caste. So that was the kind of caste discrimination that that was faced during the 1901 period. Similar episodes of caste or Dalit suppressions have come up recently in Saharanpur in Uttar Pradesh. So those were recently in news few days back. So all these episodes are related to the caste system that is prevalent in the society, or the untouchability. Now, the caste system is considered onto as a kind of ladder system, where upper caste occurs at the top of the ladder system, and you have the Dalits, which are considered as untouchables towards the lowest hierarchy. These Dalits were later on, under the Constitution of India, renamed as scheduled castes. So you have now SCs. The word Dalit itself means broken. So that's the technical meaning of this term. And you have the various leaders later on who fought for the right of the Dalit students. And there was a need to strive for equality. Along with the people who were fighting for independence during that time, there were various internal movements or social reforms that were taking place, which we would see as we move along in the higher classes. So these social movements were primarily working towards reforms in the society, or the inequalities, to remove the inequalities that existed in the society itself. So the main centers of reform movements were Dalits, women, tribals and peasants. Women were working for right to education. Dalits were demanding right into temple entry. The Dalit child was not allowed to sit along with a upper caste child in the same classroom. So those were the kinds of episodes that occurred. Now B.R. Ambedkar was the first person in the Mahar community to receive education up to college level, and later on go to England, London, for his higher education and pursue the lawyer's degree. Again, there were various demands that were coming up. Finally, when the Constitution of India was drafted, it was clearly mentioned that all the people of India were considered equal. So there were equal rights, equal opportunities for all, and the caste system or the untouchability was considered as a curse and needs to be abolished. That was proposed in the Constitution. So there was open entry for all in the government jobs. That was one of the major steps towards equality that was taken during that time. Again, there was the right to equality for the poor and the marginalized communities. There was no religion, no language, or no festival that could become compulsory in the country. Considering this fact, India became a secular nation that respected the presence of all religions on the Indian land. So with this, we cover the second chapter of the NCERT class 6 political science. We'll be covering further lectures in the upcoming classes. You can subscribe to our channel for more details. Have a good day ahead.